forecast is ugly in Houston, but we're bringing you tonight's game under the roof of Minute Maid Park. It's the pivotal Game 5 of the World Series between the Houston Astros and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, this is still anyone's series here as we get ready for Game 5.
Well, they're down 3-1, so it's do-or-die time now. That's not a good place to be, obviously, but we do see some teams play their best when their backs are up against the ropes. The key is to just take it one game at a time and not worry about how many more wins you need.
The build-up to this one is just about over. It's time for all the drama of World Series baseball on the show. And we'll have it for next. David Price will look to keep their World Series hopes alive on the mound. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
You know, David Price can still strike some people out. He doesn't throw as hard as he first did when he broke in with the Tampa Rays, but a good fastball, low 90s, good curveball, good changeup to go along with it. One of the strengths that he does, he pitches right-handers inside very well, and he knows how to win, and he knows how to compete. Expect him to hang around a long time in this one.
Hit high and deep out there to left center field. Back goes Pollock. Gone to lead off the inning. So it's a solo home run here leading off the ballgame. His third home run of this series, and the Astros take a 1-0 lead.
You talk about setting the tone for your team offensively. Everyone's allowed to relax now, pass the baton mentality, and if that's any indication where these next 9 innings are going, buckle up, fans.
At the plate, Alex Bregman. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2-2. The 2-2 coming now from Price. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout.
Great spot on that 2-2 fastball. You can't place it on the inside corner any better than that. As a hitter, there's just not a whole lot you could do with that unless you're looking for it and time it just right. Love seeing a guy that can work the inside with his fastball.
At the plate now, Michael Brantley. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land untouched. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
Hit in the air to shallow center. In comes Bellinger. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out.
That was good.
Now here's a look at the Astros starting lineup. What do you have on this lineup as they go for a championship here on the road, D-Row?
Matty, I love the way this lineup's constructed. Talking to the manager before the game, he focused on the fact that they have a pass the baton mentality. Everything's flowing for this lineup. Chance to score a lot of runs.
So now to the plate, Carlos Correa. Wow, he took something off of it there. It's 1-2.
Hey, nice job of bouncing back after a leadoff homer. Two quick outs after the bomb, and he's got a chance to get out of this.
So 2-2 now. Here now the 2-2. hit on the ground to third. Glove by Turner. Throw on to Muncy. Gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. One more for the Astros, and it comes on this solo homer. Bottom of the first coming up from Minute Maid Park. It's now 1-0 Houston. Jose Urquidy gets the call in Game 5 of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, one of the main issues is he wants to limit the amount of walks. Walked 4 in his last start, and that's a little bit too many for a starting pitcher. He's going to need much better control if he expects to pitch better in this one.
So now here is Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. And it's fouled away. And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there, really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
Fouled off. Now another 2-2. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on 3 or 4 pitches.
To the plate now, Corey Seager. 2 balls and 2 strikes to Corey Seager.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Fouled away. One out, nobody on. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it.
There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And he'll pull into second with one away. Standing in now, Justin Turner. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Swing and a line drive. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And the runner score from second as this ball game is tied 1-1. Already their second double of this first inning, guys.
Yeah, he's not fooling anybody so far, man. Like you said, that's the second double he's given up here. And if he doesn't get things figured out, it's going to be a real short out.
Stepping in now, Cody Bellinger. Line towards center field. That's in there. Base hit. Long throw to the plate. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. Get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
At the plate, Will Smith. Pitch outside. The throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
This catcher has an elite arm. Well, when you get that great of a jump at first base, it makes it a lot easier to steal second.
The 3-1. Swung on and missed, a full count now.
Looked like he swung at ball four right there. Clearly, he saw something in that pitch that he liked out of the pitcher's hand, but that wasn't a pitch he was going to do a whole lot with.
And there's ball four as this one gets away a bit.
Wow, he's looking awfully shaky to start this game, guys. That's three hits and a walk, and there's no doubt that he's fighting himself right now. See if he can get this train back on the rails here.
Now to the plate, here is Max Muncy, and the Dodgers with an opportunity for more here in the first. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
A ground ball out to the shortstop, Correa. On to Altuve for the force out, and the inning is over. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two men left on base. On to the second inning now for Minute Maid Park. Dodgers lead this one 2-1. So here's Yuli Gurriel. He'll get us started in the top of the second. 1-1 from Price. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Into the box, Kyle Tucker. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. And with two away now, let's take another look at our playoff brackets. And, of course, the question on everybody's mind, will we crown a champion here tonight? Next up for the Stros, Miles Straw will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
2-1.
Hey. 2-2 now.
He's one pitch away from striking out the side, but even more than that, to throw a donut up after your offense put up some runs, I can't tell you what that means to the boys in the dugout.
Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. Hit in the air down the right field line. Betts has a read on it. And that ends the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. Our score remains 2-1. The batter will be Gavin Lux. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
And now David Price. Dodgers pitcher trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate. Swung on but fouled off to the left. He'll try again, 1-2.
Ball.
Certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Here's a little up the middle, scooped up, and there's out number two.
Now batting, right fielder, Mookie. Betts.
Here's Mookie Betts. All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Tucker waits on it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They still lead it 2-1. New inning set to get underway, and up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Squared that one up just a little late. The 2-2. And it's fouled away. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Into the box now, Jose Urquidy. Might have jammed him a little there as this is softly hit and foul off to the left. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number 3. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. Toss on to Price at the bag as they record the out.
Now back. Second baseman.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jose Altuve. Second at bat for him. And remember, he led off the ball game with that home run to get this offense going.
Well, Maddie, we know he's got the timing on the fastball locked in. That's what he got a hold of on that home run in the previous at bat. You do not come off the heater. Have to be leery of the off speed, but stay on the fastball. He's got to throw it again.
Can't connect there. It's 2-2. A base hit on the line.
Hey, that was 8 straight up until that base hit right there. Let's see if the offense gets something rolling now.
And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the 2-out single.
Yeah, and that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you can extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
Bryce pauses. Here it is on 2-1. Hit back up the middle. A dive, but he can't get a glove on it. It's through for a base hit.
Two quick outs from the 8-9 guys in the order, but the top of the order, it's a different story. A knock and then another single back-to-back, and now you've got traffic with the big guys coming up.
At the plate now, Michael Brantley. Good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Now, you don't have to be a genius to figure out what the plan of attack is. It is ambush city on this guy. Two hits on back-to-back pitches, and this guy comes unglued.
Softly hit to short. He's got it. On the first, and the Astros can't cash in as that ends the inning. Two left for the Astros. They still trail it here, 2-1. That'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Corey Seager. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. On the run, this one in on him, and
one
he
ball,
can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Really tied him up on that one.
Yikes, he kind of looked clueless on that swing right there, Matt. If I'm pitching, I'm going right back to that same pitch.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
2-2 is the count.
Now a pitch swung on and foul tipped right off the mask. It sounded like of the home plate umpire, and that cannot feel too good, I wouldn't imagine. The 2-2.
Count is full.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. Next to dig in, Justin Turner. He doubled his last time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here. After fouling off the second one, I got to step out of the box, adjust my batting gloves, and tell myself there's no chance he's tripling up on that pitch.
Throw gets him, two down.
The center fielder, number 35, Cody Bellinger.
And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger. He delivered an RBI single in his last trip. Chopper to short. Barehanded at his knees. What an outstanding play to end the inning. Dodgers down in order as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Thank you, Heidi. Here's Carlos Correa now. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Hit hard down the line, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but he's going to be tested here. Four, five, and coming up this part of the lineup.
Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Swing and a ground ball to third. Turner's got to get rid of it. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And as you see there, just 1 mile an hour separating these two arms so far. 96 on one hand, 95 on the other. So bases are empty with one gone. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. The 1-1 home. Fouled off. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2.
And obviously, this guy's a double threat up there. He can run, and he can go yard, too. You don't want to walk him because he might steal a base on you, but you don't want to groove a fastball either because he can take you out of the yard.
And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
That's the difference in today's games. Pitchers will throw any pitch in any catch. The batter was able to deliver on a 3-2 breaking ball.
By Price and a dive, but he's back. To the plate now, Kyle Tucker inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes.
Outside,
and misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away.
Now that number three.
Stepping in next, Miles Straw. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Line hard toward right center. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's now a 2-2 ball game.
Now back.
And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Team Maldonado. Turner's got it to second for one. Throw to Muncy to finish the double play. That retires the side. They make it look easy, don't they? Around the horn for the double play to end the inning. More coming up from game five after this. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Now to bat, Will Smith drew a base on balls his first time up. A 1-1. Fouled away. Ready on 1-2. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Altuve fields it cleanly, and there's one down now.
Not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
One gone now in the Dodger fourth, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. Now the 1-1 pitch. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. Throw gets him, two down.
The left fielder, number 11, AJ Pollock.
Next to stand in is
AJ Pollock.
Two runs, three hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Hey, you think back to the early innings right there. You thought this guy would have been hitting his showers. A credit to him. He's been able to regroup, find his mechanics, and find a way to stay in this game.
The 1-2.
No, that's out.
Him at the plate, a called third strike, and the inning comes to a close. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. We'll head to the fifth, tied at two. Jordan Alvarez will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
He's hitting for the Astros. Number 44.
A 3-2 now from Price. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
It looked like this at-bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started green. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
So now to the plate, Jose Altuve. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Bases are empty, one man out. Towards second. On to first, and the Price is right here, two away.
The third baseman of the team, Alex Bregman.
That'll bring up the former first-rounder Alex Bregman. Last time through was a base hit. Two runs, five hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Price sets his sights. Here comes the 3-2. And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Man at first with two out in a 2-2 ball game. Throw over to the bag. Dive, but it's back.
Runner, yes, yes.
There goes Bregman off the first. In there. Now the throw.
Hey.
is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
Some managers treat the postseason as a time to be aggressive, and that's exactly the case here. They had the speed burner on the move, and it worked out nicely for him. Just got to drive him in now.
Ground ball right side. It's flagged down deep in the hole. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
This is a head-scratcher. I mean, that's the shortest throw on the infield, and somehow he lets it sail wide of the mark for an E4. A couple more like that, and doubt starts to creep into the second baseman's mind.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Carlos Correa, and their runners at the corners now. The set and the 1-1 to 1-2 now. Runners on first and third, two away. And that misses 2-2. Here it is. Fly ball right down the line and left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
He set the 2-2. Hit out towards second. And that's by him into right field for a base hit. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third.
Dan, as a former infielder, I apologize for him. Nothing's more frustrating or upsets you more as a defender than making an error and seeing that guy come around the score.
You know what? And that's one of those cases as a pitcher, D-Will. There's not much you can do. Listen, there are physical and there are mental errors. And you just have to, as a pitcher, go ahead and look past that now and try to pick up your teammate and try to get an out any way you can.
Tony Gonsolin trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. Into the box, Yuli Gurriel. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one. It's up onto the train tracks and out of here. A three-run shot down the line in left. His second home run of the series as they open it up to 6-2 now.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Into the box now, Kyle Tucker. Strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. Bottom of the fifth coming up. It's the Astros 6 and the Dodgers 2. Christian Javier, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and up next will be Gavin Lux.
If you look at their win percentage or something like that right now, gotta be honest, the odds are obviously stacked against them. But I'm looking for them to show me something right here.
Maybe they get back in this game. Maybe they don't. But I want to see what kind of at-bats they put together. This is where you have to lock in as a team. Every guy has to go up to the plate and have a good, productive AB to get this team going.
Chris Taylor steps into the on-deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning. The 1-1 home.
Ball.
One out, nobody on. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
Liner toward right center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
At the plate now, Mookie Betts. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Dodgers down in order. They still trail here. It's 6-2. Scott Alexander takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Dodgers, number 75, Scott Alexander.
Top half of the sixth about to get started. And digging in is the outfielder, Miles Straw. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Line drive, base hit. So the Astros put a man aboard to get the inning underway.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy has had a monster postseason so far.
Now, Martin Maldonado. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher. And now some action in that Dodger bullpen as a left-hander has begun to get loose. The 2-2. Straw on at first. Nobody out. Now a throw over, and he's back standing. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Grounded up the first baseline. Fielded cleanly. The second for one. Over to Muncy, and they double him up.
Made him throw a lot of pitches in that at bat, but he'll take the double play as a trade-off for sure.
Steven Souza gets the call as a pinch hitter, and he'll get a chance with two out and the bases empty. Bases are empty here with two men out. Can't find his own there, and it's 3-1.
One thing that can nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise right through. He's not known for his offensive prowess, but he's putting together a real nice at bat here.
The 3-1.
Full count.
chance at bringing this one back. It's up and out of here into the archways. A solo home run there for Steven Souza, and the lead is now 7-2.
One of the best qualities of this pitcher is keeping the ball in the ballpark. He's not an easy guy to get the ball up in the air again, so he's going to have to regroup a little bit here. He's not used to giving up home runs.
In now, Jose Altuve. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Two out, nobody on. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Here he comes again. 1-2. This one's down to third. Turner has it. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's the Astros 7 and the Dodgers 2. Josh James please. Enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 39.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Corey Seager. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Brantley on the move, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out.
Now that the third baseman, Justin.
Next to hit is Justin Turner, 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Bases are empty, one man out. Back up the middle, and that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Well and good.
So now to the plate, Cody Bellinger. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Waits. Now the pitch.
Ball.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Now the payoff pitch home, and that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with only one away.
Now batting, the catcher.
Here now is Will Smith. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll two.
1-2 now as that's in there at the knees.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
Still Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Turner over at second. Bellinger at first. One gone. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Strong falls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out.
Up next to the Dodgers, the first baseman, Matt.
So two gone now for the Dodgers in the sixth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. Set and the 1-1 pitch. Slider laid off for a ball.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Two men are on with two men out. High and deep to left. This one's got plenty of distance. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, his second home run of the series, and that lead is trimmed to 7-5 here.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Austin Pruitt finds in right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching. Plate, A.J. Pollock. Fastball in there, 3-2.
Got to look out.
Bouncer up the middle. There is Altuve. Onto the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. But the Dodgers strike for three, all courtesy of the three-run home run. The 2-3-4 hitters now to start the seventh. It's the Astros 7 and the Dodgers 5. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Corey Knebel is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number 6 spot following the double switch. Matt Beatty will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
Standing in now, Michael Brantley. And lays off a pitch down and away. Ball two. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. He's 1-for-3. To 2-2 now. One out, nobody on. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And the throw to first is there to record the second out. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Carlos, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. The 2-1 home. It's a fastball that misses.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
He's set, and the payoff pitch. Count remains full. And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Yuli Gurriel will stand in as he's accounted for one of the biggest at-bats of the game so far. A three-run shot back in the fifth that's really energized his ball club. Correa breaking for second on the ground to the left side. Oh, and he overshoots his first baseman as it's over his head. And he is going to score now all the way from first on a play that was nothing short of a disaster all the way around.
Man, that was a comedy of errors right there. They're kicking the ball all over the yard, and the runner on first comes all the way around to score. So you wonder why managers retire early? There's your answer right there.
Joe Kelly will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh.
Number 17, Joe Kelly.
Kyle Tucker. It's 1-2.
1-2.
Hey, this is a big pitch right here. Can't allow them to attack on any more runs. Let's see if he attacks his own or buries something in the dirt.
Well, the shortstop's got him played perfectly as he takes this in for the third out. Astros forced to settle for only the one run. Time to get up and stretch here at Minute Maid Park. The Astros lead it 8-5. Pedro Baez gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh. Last half of the seventh here, and set to go is the second baseman, Gavin Lux. Hit sharply toward the right side, but this will be gloved at second as he didn't have far to go for the out.
Now batting, first baseman, Matt Beatty.
Matt Beatty stepping in. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. Bases are empty, one man out. Pitch taken, several inches below the zone, in fact. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. The 2-1.
Nope, ball.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Three and one, here it is.
Count
just
full.
Behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Ooh-wee. That was some smoke right there. High fire, right on by.
The 3-2 pitch. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
The right here. Mookie.
So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. The 1-2 pitch. Beatty, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. High in the air down the right field line. Tucker is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
The batter, number 5, shortstop, Corey.
Here's Corey Seager.
Seager.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Hey, love the confidence in that pitch right there, going right after one of the better hitters on this team, not afraid to execute.
Ball two as the breaking ball misses inside.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. A runner on first with two away. And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch one more time. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with a man in scoring position.
Next, it'll be Justin Turner. And, Dan, this could be a real make-or-break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide at first. Pitch one more time. Hard hit to the left side, but taken in out there at short. Almost big trouble there, but he'll wind up stranding two as the side is retired. Couple of walks in the inning, but nothing on the scoreboard. More on tap from game 5 after this. Tommy Kingley has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 44, Tommy Kingley.
ready to begin the eighth, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. The 1-1 home.
Two balls, one strike.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Now a ball ripped into deep center field. Bellinger is there and he makes the catch for the out.
Now batter, catcher, Martini.
Time now for our starter comparison, and that tells the story. As you can see, neither guy able to get past five innings. Now at the plate, Martin Maldonado. He was a double play victim last time around.
He doesn't have to worry about that in this situation, Matty. No one on base right now. Try and get something up so you can drive the baseball.
That's down.
Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Here's the pitch. Bounce towards the second baseman. Reined in. And that's the second out. Alexis Diaz will pinch hit here with two outs and the bases empty.
Number 16. Alexis Diaz.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Ball and two strikes. Here it is. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and the ball is even at 2-2. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Fouled off. Once again, a 3-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They're on top by 3-8-5. Joe Smith is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 38, Joe Smith.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Swing and a looper to left. Bregman ranging into the outfield, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Hey, excellent job right there leading off the inning with a base hit. We got to keep this line moving. We cannot stop. Nobody can make an out. We have to find a way to put two men, maybe three men, put some pressure on this defense.
Plate now, Will Smith.
Right.
A ball and two strikes now.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
Bellinger gets his lead at first, nobody out. 2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. The 2-2. He swung on and missed. He got him.
I think that's one of the toughest calls for an umpire to make. The check swing appeal, hitters rarely feel like they went, and I don't think he likes getting rung up there by the first base umpire. But looking at it, it's hard to say for sure that he didn't go around.
And he popped him up, and that's going to land foul. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Lifted in the air out towards left center. After it is Brantley. And he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
Up next to the bottom, the left fielder, A.J. Mullen.
Ryan Pressly enters the game in a save situation, but he'll be asked to get four outs here instead of the standard three. A.J. Pollock will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. The 2-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Get it ready, big boy. This guy's throwing three digits right here. The best way I can help the fans is 90 to 92, you can usually see seams. 92 to 95, it starts to really quicken up on you. Over three digits, you're seeing a white blur.
Nearly got the inside, but ruled the ball.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. Next for the Dodgers, Gavin Lux. And a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two, swinging. The 1-2 gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. Big time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. More coming up from game five after this. Blake Treinen enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. To the plate next will be Jose Altuve. He grounded out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
That's the ball.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Fouled away. The 2-2 pitch. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Smoke toward the hole, and that is in the right field, so the leadoff man's aboard here to kick off the ninth.
Pitcher executed his pitch, good sinker down and in, got the hitter to beat it into the ground. Sometimes there's nothing you can do about it as a pitcher.
In in now, Alex Bregman. Outside in a full count, 3-2. Nobody out, runner on first. Throw over to the bag, and he's back easily. Hit back up the middle. A bare hand for one. On to first, and they get the double play.
We don't get to see the glove toss enough, but boy, it can really help save some time, and it looks good to boot. That's smooth.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. Hit hard on the ground towards second. He's got it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Nothing doing there for Houston. They're on top by 3, 8-5. Now at the plate is Matt Beatty. And obviously they'll need a ninth inning rally here if this series is going to make it to a game six. And he's behind 1-2. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
I like how he worked him backwards for that strikeout there. He wasn't showing the fastball early in the at-bat, but then went back-to-back once he had the hitter down in the count.
So now to the plate, Mookie Betts. Oh, he was fooled that time on a pitch away as he went around for strike two. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Corey Seager.
Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. And their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. Two out, nobody on. High, 2-1 now. Now the 2-1. Dodgers down to their final strike. Struck him out, and it's over. They are World Series champions.
Wow! World Series champions. The only thing that could have made this sweeter would have been doing it in front of the home crowd. But hey, they're not complaining. Believe me, now they can look forward to celebrating during the parade as they bring the World Series trophy home. What a moment for this team, this organization, and that city.
Back now on the show. More reactions now to this series clinching victory. And down on the field, we'll get a chance to watch the presentation of the Commissioner's Trophy to the new world champs. For my partners Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire Fall Classic crew, I'm Matt Van. You've been watching the World Series.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 8 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Dodgers, 5 runs, 6 hits, 2 errors. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 36 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.